guys, welcome back with the man. I would say without him, we all wouldn't be here because he's the chairman of the Munich Security Conference, former diplomat Wolfgang Ischinger. Welcome. Schön, dass Sie hier sind.
Good morning.
Nice to have you here.
Great.
Good morning. Thank you so much for being here with us. After interviewing a lot of politicians and also our president, we just wanted to thank you a lot because you and the team, which I'm sure you had a lot of busy days and sleepless nights to make this happen and bring all these people from around the world. Thank you so much.
It's quite an effort for the entire team. And I can't thank the team enough. You know, of course, what you see is like the tip of the iceberg here for this weekend.
Of course.
But it took weeks and months of diligent preparation. Think of everything from the logistics, the security, the police, the catering, the transport arrangements, chaos in the streets of Munich, keeping the citizenry, let's say, from getting too upset, which is also not so easy. So, you know, it's not only what happens in the main hall, it's also what happens outside.
Outside.
So it's a big effort, and I'm delighted that so far it went really well.
Definitely. We're going to talk more about the conference, but I wanted to start with your sweater.
Yeah.
A lot of people have been talking about it on social media. Can you tell us more about it? I prefer it more than the tuxedo.
Well, it's a very simple story. At Christmas time, you know, in my family, as everywhere else, you exchange gifts. And my son and my grandson, who is 4 years old, they had decided to give me this. And it's, of course, not only a gift for daddy or grandpa, it's also a demonstration. And this is why I decided to wear it at the opening session, to demonstrate that this conference is about many things. It's about peace in the Middle East. It's about, you know, the role of China. It's about the phenomenon of Donald Trump and how that affects transatlantic relations. But it is essentially and first and foremost about the self-preservation and the future of Europe. Europe is fraying at the edges. We have Brexit, and this is, of course,
the missing
if you star. If you want to define it, it's a kind of a Brexit T-shirt, not a T-shirt or a sweatshirt of joy. It's more an expression of concern, because I happen to believe that first, Brexit is not good for the United Kingdom. Brexit is not good for the European Union, and Brexit is not good for the ability of 500 million Europeans to defend their interest in a world that is, quote unquote, from the national security document of the United Nations, that is increasingly dominated by great power rivalries. I'm not happy about these developments, but what this means is that Europe needs to stand up. Europe needs to be cohesive. Europe needs to speak with one voice. And now we're losing an important voice, London. That's really too bad. So I wanted to express that.
You said the situation in the world is difficult right now. It was your 11th MSC. Was it the most difficult one for you?
Well, you know, organizing these events is difficult, even if there is... if the number of current conflicts may have been less numerous in previous years.
Yeah.
So I wouldn't really qualify it the most difficult one. I would qualify it as one of the most important ones, though, in the time that I overlook. I've been doing this now as chairman for a decade, but in the previous decade or so, I was a simple participant. So I think I can overlook the last two or two and a half decades, and this is a watershed moment. It's about the global international system. It's about the transatlantic alliance. It's about human rights. It's about you know, international institutions like NATO. Is NATO should NATO survive? The Russians feel it shouldn't. Donald Trump has expressed his own views about it. Lots of concern about it. We had this as an important issue here and among many other issues.
What would you say is the most important topic at the moment?
Well, it's very hard for me to prioritize and say this is the one that's more important, because I'm sure some of our speakers would wildly disagree with me. You know, the Chinese would have different priorities than some Europeans. For me personally, there is one issue which I want to, to highlight in the future more, and it actually came out in our session earlier this morning. The current international legal system based on the Charter of the United Nations is unfortunately being interpreted in our practical day-to-day operation of the international system increasingly as a system which serves to protect the interests of dictators. International law should, if you ask me, be designed to protect the interests of mankind, of humans.
Exactly.
So what I want to bring out is that in the future, we should work to change the way we interpret international law. We should turn it from a dictatorship protection system into a human security system. That's very ambitious. And I know that we as a conference organizer, we can only make a tiny contribution. But I think starting a discussion about it and starting it with you guys is already a step in the right direction.
That's true. Mm. One step at a time. Everybody, you know, this conference has been very serious. A lot of police, obviously highly security. But are there any fun behind the scenes that have been happening or funny moments that we can share with the audience? I'm sure there's something.
Oh, yeah. I mean, there are all sorts of things that are happening. You know, again, I think the picture of the tip of the iceberg is not inappropriate. What you see on television and on live stream in the ballroom, the speeches, that's the tip of the iceberg. We organize, in the course of this long weekend, more than 1,000 bilateral meetings. We have reserved an entire floor or two of the facility for these bilateral meetings in sort of like 30-minute intervals. So there are hundreds and many hundreds of meetings are going on. Now, not all of these are much fun. Some of these meetings are very serious, but they're necessary. This is part of international diplomacy. But we also have fun parts. For example, 2 weeks ago, I got a phone call from Ivanka Trump. Would it be okay if she came? Wow.
Did she call you personally?
Well, somebody arranged the call. Okay. Yeah, she didn't have my cell phone number, but okay. Somebody arranged this. So we had a conversation about this, and she explained to me that she would be interested if she would be invited to talk about empowerment of women. Mm-hmm. That's been her agenda for quite a bit. So we thought about it, and we actually found a way to include in our side events, in our overall program, a couple of events that fit this these themes, yeah. This topic. So yes, we gave the green light. She came, and I, in discussing this with her personally, I said, if you come, you know, we also have a lot of discussion about the Middle East. Why don't you bring your husband? So sure enough, they showed up together. And now here comes my little anecdote. Ivanka Trump is, of course, the daughter of the first wife of President Trump. And her mother became rather prominent as a very young woman, as a very successful ski racer, mm-hmm. in her home country, Czech Republic. So for Ivanka Trump, skiing has also been an important, athletic part, mm-hmm. of her activities. And when she found out that in my earlier life, I made my living when I went to law school as a ski instructor. So now we've arranged to meet for skiing at some point.
Okay.
We need to figure out exactly when and where, but it's agreed.
Okay, it's good to know that you guys are planning some fun times.
Absolutely.
And make sure to take some selfies or post some pictures on social media for us to see. And sadly, our time is coming to an end. We would love to chat more with you. And maybe we should get ourselves a sweater.
Yeah, sure.
And Europe needs to survive and be strong. I think we can make a very, very important contribution to global peace if we are united. That's what it's all about.
Definitely. And for us, anything that would support global peace as young people, we're rooting for it. It's about time. A lot of our followers have been engaging and saying that. So that's the message of young people to the conference and everybody in it. Please get engaged with us. Share your comments on the hashtag YourMSC. Thank you so much for watching and thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure.